Is anybody here bearing Christopher? Don't deny your name. Any Christopher here, raise your hand. At the back there, see there, some of them. Do you know what Christopher means? Christopher, Christ. The story about Saint Christopher, how his name became Christopher. He was a very huge, strong man. And in his place, there was a river that had strong current. People couldn't cross without getting swept away. So he dedicated himself to carrying people across. He would carry on his shoulder and cross. One day he carried a small boy. And he discovered that this boy was heavier than anybody has ever carried. And he was wondering. The guy was almost sinking him. But he mustered his energy and carried the boy across. It was when he crossed over that the real person emerged. He discovered it was Jesus he was carrying. Jesus now came in his glory. That's how he was called Christopher. In other words, Jesus appeared to him and told him, all the while you've been carrying this helpless, it is me you have been carrying. Because whatsoever you do to the least of my brothers, that you do unto me. So his name is Christopher. He carries God. He carries Jesus. Christopher means to carry God. But your name is Christopher. In your car, you have never carried any pregnant woman or old woman who is in need. But any girl that is wearing micro mini and spaghetti once, even when they are not telling you to stop, even if you are in 1 kilometer, you will reverse. Woo! Nekebinaga, where are you going to? You have never carried any man or old woman in need, even those who are pregnant. But whenever you see any skimpily dressed, you will carry. You have carried all the whole prostitute in zone 4, zone 5, zone 6. You have carried all of them. And your name is what? Christopher. You are not Christopher, you are Christopros. Zacchaeus' problem, his name is in total disagreement with what? His lifestyle. All of us are like that. Your name is Mary. But there is nothing there is no humility about it. Sometimes even those who bear the wrong name that seems to show the right attitude. Some Linda. Do you know what Linda means? Linda means snake. But some people who are called Linda, they are the most gentle, quiet, nice person. They don't behave like snake. But you, Chinaza, the poison that comes from your mouth is worse than a real snake itself. So by name, many of us are Zacchaeus. He was a chief tax collector. Tax collectors were regarded as sinners, and it's not for any wrong reason. Why? They were the ones collecting tax for the Roman authority. Israel was under Roman occupation. And as Rome did, Rome taxed every territory they conquered. But Rome will use your people. So, anybody who was a tax collector, first of all, the people of Israel will see you as a saboteur. You are conniving with the Romans, our oppressors. Then the second problem is Rome, for instance, we give them a target. Rome does not pay them. Rome will give them a target and say, whatever is on top is your own. So sometimes they even pay that target in advance. Then they will now want to recoup their money by any means and to add something on top. So let's say, for instance, that Zax was in charge of Treadmore. For the year 2019, Rome could say, okay, your target is 20 million. Zach will now look for every mean to raise up to 50 million. And then he will give Rome how much? 20, and collect the remainder. That's how he became rich. That's why the people hated them. And Rome didn't care. If you like, multiply it 10 times. What is important to us is that you should give us our share. That's why tax collectors were hated. They collected more than they were supposed to. If you remember when John was baptizing, I think in Luke 5, and many people were coming to him, different people. Tax collectors too came. What must we do? He said, don't exact more than you are told. Don't take more than you are told. So anybody who takes more than he or she is supposed to take, either from society or from another person, is what? Is Zacchaeus, the bad Zacchaeus self.